Canadian Medical Association says the potential benefits to be derived from cessation of smoking place it at a level of importance in preventative medicine with the pasteurization of milk. Smoking cessation expert Kendra Smith.
The third hook cigarettes have on you is the psychological hook, and that is the most powerful, the most complex, the most difficult to overcome. Friends and jobs have come and go, but you've always had cigarettes. And so you have a history with cigarettes. And the psychological addiction may last weeks, months, years even, because you can become quite nostalgic thinking about the good old days of being with friends and sitting around and smoking, playing cards. So this is the hook that you really have to focus on. As nasty as nicotine is, you've gotten rid of it in a week's time. It's out of your body. The only thing left is your mind. And your mind can be your best friend. It can be your worst enemy. It's almost as if you've gone to war with yourself. Part of you may say, yes, I want to stay off cigarettes. I've made it this far. I'm going to go. But every once in a while, that little voice comes up and says, it'd be nice right now to have a smoke. Watch the trickiness of the psychological addiction. It can hit you when you least expect it and when you're most vulnerable. When you hit a personal crisis, what you've always done before is reach for the cigarette. Be careful. Watch your thoughts. Stay on track. Continue on with the breathing that you've been doing, deep breathing in and out. That'll help you get through. Stay aware. Watch your thoughts.
Susan Cullen facing her psychological attachment to smoking.
I think week three is sort of the week for me to prepare for being a non-smoker now. I mean, the last couple of weeks I've been dealing with getting all the nicotine out of my system and trying to get a handle on my habits. So now I'm going to start working on the future, being a non-smoker, trying not to deal with the fact that I want a cigarette, because I don't. I'm not going to smoke again. So it's just to deal with little things that nag at you here and there and try to fill the time with cleaning, exercises, whatever, bicycling.
Escapist behaviors. Watch those arguments. You may say, well, I've come this far and I don't want people telling me that when I can smoke and when I can't smoke. There's a new policy at my workplace, not going to do that. Be careful. That's all escapism. Watch your mind. Watch your thoughts. Stay on guard. Keep up everything you've been doing, the exercising, the deep breathing, so that it becomes part of your life.